Imagine a fighter jet so advanced it could vanish from radar and dominate airspace, but it never saw combat. Throughout aviation history, many such groundbreaking jets were canceled before they could change the world. Some were stealthier than anything flying today, and some could take off vertically or hit Mach 3, yet none of them made it into full service. In this video, we'll uncover 10 incredible fighter jets projects that had serious potential but were scrapped along the way. The Salt Mirage 4000. A French prototype twinjet fighter aircraft developed by Dassault from their Mirage 2000 to compete with the F-15 and Soviet Su-27 during the late Cold War. With twin engines, advanced radar and extended range, it was everything the lighter Mirage 2000 wasn't. Big, powerful, and built for dominance, France eventually chose the cheaper Mirage 2000 for its air force, leaving the Mirage 4000 as an orphaned prototype sitting in a museum. Despite its limited lifespan, it was fast, agile, and equipped with advanced avionics for its time. It had the potential to lead European air power for a generation if given a chance, but political and budget concerns killed it early, just as it was ready to shine. The IAI Lavi. This was an advanced multi-role fighter jet developed by Israel in the 1980s. It featured a delta wing and canard configuration along with cutting-edge fly-by-wire controls for high maneuverability. It incorporated advanced avionics tailored to Israel's combat needs. The Lavi made its first flight in 1986 and performed well in testing, demonstrating impressive agility and advanced technology. However, the program's cost ballooned significantly, becoming the most expensive project in Israeli defense history at the time. The US, which was partially funding the program, grew concerned that the Lavi would compete with American aircraft in the export market. Internal political debates, budget constraints, and external pressure from the US led to the project's cancellation in 1987. Though never operational, technologies from the Lavi later influenced other Israeli defense programs and collaborations. The Hawker Siddeley P-1154. The P-1154 was Britain's plan to build the world's first supersonic vertical takeoff and landing fighter jet during the 1960s. It was a direct successor to the subsonic Harrier, but promised Mach 2 performance alongside full V-stall capabilities. Developed for both the Royal Air Force and Royal Navy, it suffered from political disagreements and shifting military budgets. Eventually, the project was cancelled in favor of the F-4 Phantom II. If completed, the P-1154 could have revolutionized close air support and naval air power decades ahead of its time. It was a rare example of ambition, exceeding both funding and technology at once. Today, it stands as the jet that could have made Harrier history even greater. A British marvel that never made it past blueprints. The Mitsubishi X-2 Shinshin. The Mitsubishi X-2, known as Shinshin, was Japan's bold entry into the stealth fighter world, built to test technologies for an indigenous fifth-generation jet. It featured thrust-vectored engines, AESA radar, stealth shaping, and fly-by-light controls, making it a true research marvel for Japan's defense industry. In 2016, it completed a successful test flight demonstrating Tokyo's capability to build cutting-edge stealth aircraft from scratch. However, Japan later shifted priorities and joined the UK and Italy in developing the sixth-generation GCAP program, abandoning plans to mass-produce the X-2, although it never became a frontline fighter. Its tech laid the foundation for Japan's future air dominance capability. The Sukhoi Su-47 Burkut. This is an experimental Russian fighter aircraft developed by Sukhoi in the late 1990s. It featured a striking forward swept wing design that gave it exceptional agility and maneuverability at high angles of attack. The aircraft also incorporated stealthy features such as reduced radar cross-section and internal weapon bays in concept, though not fully realized in the prototype. Only one prototype was built, designated S-37 initially before being renamed Su-47. It first flew in 1997 and served as a testbed for technologies later used in the Su-57. The program was ultimately cancelled due to high costs, Limited funding post-Soviet Union collapse and the complexity of maintaining the forward swept wing structure. Despite its cancellation, the Su-47 provided valuable data for future aircraft development. Mikoyan Mig 144 Flatpak. Russia's 1.44, built as a direct response to the American F-22 Raptor, aiming to become the Soviet Union's first fifth-generation stealth fighter. It featured a delta-wing canard thrust vectoring engines and a fly-by-wire system, everything needed to compete with Western designs, but the Soviet Union collapsed before it could be fully tested, and the Russian Federation lacked the funds to continue the program. The only prototype flew once in 2000, long after its peak relevance, and the project was quietly cancelled in favor of Sukhoi's rival PAK-FA design. Despite its brief life, the MiG 1.44 showed remarkable potential with advanced stealth shaping and super maneuverability features. It could have made Russia a stealth leader years before the Su-57 ever flew. The Northrop F-20 Tiger Shark. This was a lightweight single-engine fighter developed in the 1980s as an advanced evolution of the F-5 Freedom Fighter. It featured a powerful General Electric F-404 engine, given an excellent thrust-to-weight ratio and quick acceleration. Designed for export to US allies, the F-20 included modern avionics, radar, and ability to fire beyond visual range missiles. The aircraft demonstrated outstanding reliability. Despite its promising performance, the F-20 faced stiff competition from other American fighters like the F-16, which were sold at subsidized prices through government programs. Potential buyers preferred the F-16 due to its twin-engine option and broader political backing. Ultimately, the project was cancelled due to poor market interest and strategic policy decisions, not technical flaws. McDonnell Douglas A-12 Avenger II. Nicknamed the Flying Dorito for its triangular shape, the A-12 Avenger II was a proposed American attack aircraft from General Dynamics and McDonnell Douglas. It was a flying-wing carrier-borne bomber with stealth shaping, internal payload bays, and cutting-edge radar-absorbing materials. But technical challenges and skyrocketing costs crippled the project, which was eventually cancelled in 1991 after billions were spent. It was one of the biggest military program failures in US history, yet it laid the groundwork for future stealth aircraft. Had it worked, it would have been the first operational stealth jet on an aircraft carrier. Decades before the F-35C, the A-12 aimed to give the Navy invisible strike power. Instead, it became a costly lesson in ambition over execution. The Northrop YF-23 Black Widow II. The YF-23 was America's stealthy challenger in the race to build the next generation air superiority fighter during the Cold War's final days. Designed to be faster, stealthier, and with greater range than its rival, the YF-22, it impressed many engineers with its smooth diamond wing shape and radar evading features. While it lacked the extreme agility of the YF-22, it was more advanced in stealth and speed, and could supercruise without afterburners. But in 1991, the Air Force chose the YF-22 for production, largely due to the Lockheed's stronger political ties and the perception that maneuverability was more important. The YF-23 quietly disappeared from public view after that. Despite its unmatched promise, many believe it was the better aircraft and that America passed on the more future-proof jet. If it had been chosen, it might still be dominating the skies today. The Black Widow II remains one of history's greatest what-if fighters. The YF-12 was a high-speed interceptor based on the legendary SR-71 Blackbird and could fly at over Mach 3 while carrying long-range missiles to defend US airspace. Its radar system was cutting-edge and its speed was unmatched. Even today, very few aircraft can compare. It was designed during the Cold War to intercept Soviet bombers before they could reach North America. However, the program was shut down primarily due to high costs and shifting priorities during the Vietnam War era, leaving only three prototypes built. Maintaining such a high-speed aircraft was also expensive, and the Air Force favored versatility over speed. The YF-12 never went into full production, even though it proved itself in testing. If deployed, it could have been the fastest combat jet in history. With this, we're signing off for today, but stay tuned as we bring you more interesting videos from the buzz. We'll see you guys again in our next video. Bye-bye.